Alright, hello and welcome back to Undertale. So, now that we're out of the ruins, we're gonna go continue on exploring through the underground cavern where the monsters live. We've met Sans and Papyrus, so Sans wants me to go entertain his brother. He's looking for a human. Sans seems to already know what a human is, though, and has met them before. Let's see, what do we got over here? This is a box. You can put an item inside or take an item out. The same box will appear later, so don't worry about coming back. Sincerely, a box lover. Now, wait a second. How does the box move? Like a magical teleporting box, I guess? Quantum physics box. We'll call it that. Use the box. There's a glove inside. Okay, I'll take that, I guess. Oh, what do we got? Snowdrake flutters forth. Some kind of a bird thing. It's like a chicken. Let's check him out. Snowdrake, attack 12, defense 7. This team comedian fights to keep a captive audience. My fave ice cereals, Frosted. That one was pretty lame. It smells like a wet pillow. Ew. I guess I'll laugh at his joke. You laugh at Snowdrake's pun. Sea bass! Dad was wrong! pleased with his cool joke. Alright, I can spare him now. Goodbye, Snowdrake. Ooh, 12 gold. How nice. Let's see, what do we got up here? We got like a nice little river with a fishing pole. It's a fishing rod affixed to the ground. Reel it in?
Sure.
All that's attached to the end is a photo of a weird-looking monster. Call me, here's my number. You decide not to call. Yeah, I'll pass. Oh, here's the skeletons again.
So, as I was saying about Undyne... Oh my god, what is that? Holy shit.
Jeez.
Sans, oh my god. Is that... a human?
Actually, I think that's a rock.
Oh!
Hey, what's that in front of the rock?
Oh my god! Is that a human?
Yeah.
Oh my god! Sans, I finally did it! Undyne will... I'll be so... popular!
Human, you shall not pass this area. I, the Great Papyrus, will stop you. I will then capture you. You will be delivered to the capital. Then... I'm not sure what's next. In any case, continue only if you dare.
Well, that went well. Don't sweat it, kid. I'll keep an eye socket out for you. So Papyrus, I guess is trying to be a sentry, so he thinks he needs to capture a human in order to get recognition. So he's kind of like, it's not really his job to do that, he's just doing it because he wants the job. Ice Cap struts into view. You have very tiny legs and arms, little man. Little snowman with your twisty nose. Attack 11, defense 4. This teen wonders why it isn't named Ice Hat. What a great hat, mine. Oh, okay. He also wants a hat for his nose. Okay. You manage to tear your eyes away from Ice Cap's hat. It looks annoyed.
Hello, my hat's up here.
Whoa, hey, what are you doing? Whoa, he's shooting stuff at me. Okay. Secretly checking if you're looking at its head. I'm gonna keep ignoring you. You continue not looking at Ice Cap's hat. It seems defeated. Okay, I'll ignore you too. He's angsty. Angsty little snowman with a hat is desperate for attention. And he's ignoring me. I'm gonna steal his hat. It melts in your hands. What can I say? Ice Cap is no more. I'll compliment him. You inform Ice Cap that it still looks fine. I wanted you to see me as cool. Ice Cap doesn't mind its identity. Okay, you can go now. There's some narration on this cardboard box. You observe the well-crafted sentry station. Who could have built this, you ponder? I bet it was that very famous royal guardsman. No, not yet a very famous royal guardsman. One thing I like is that the Sans and Papyrus, they're puns on fonts. The Papyrus is, all, everything that he says is actually in the Papyrus font. And really large text for some reason. I think it's because he talks really loud, I'm assuming. And the Sans that actually talks in Comic Sans. Except when he's in a bad mood, apparently. Let's see, what do we got here? Absolutely no moving. Okay. Did something move? Was it my imagination? I can only see moving things. If something was moving, for example, a human, I'll make sure it never moves again. It's not very friendly. Doggo blocks the way. Let's check him out. Doggo, attack 13, defense 7. Easily excited by movement. Hobbies include squirrels. It's a good hobby for a dog. Don't move an inch. Okay, I won't. Doggo can't seem to find anything. I'm gonna try to pet him. You pet Doggo. What? I've been pet. Pat, pat, pet, pot, pet, pot, pet. Doggo has been pet. I can spare it now. You won. You earned 30 gold. Something pet me. Something that isn't moving. I'm gonna need some dog treats for this. Someone's been smoking dog treats. Oh, jeez. That's, that's not appropriate. Oh, okay. Let me ring the bell. What's up, doggo? Hello? Is anybody there? No? Oh. Well, I guess he can't see me if I'm not moving. Oh, hey, Sans. What's up, buddy? Hey. There's something important to remember. My brother has a very special attack. If you see a blue attack, don't move, and it won't hurt you. So like the dog. No moving. Here's an easy way to keep it in mind. Imagine a stop sign. When you see a stop sign, you stop, right? Stop signs are red, so imagine a blue stop sign instead. Simple, right? When fighting, think about blue stop. Why is that in yellow? Okay, Sans. Whatever you say, buddy. Oh. Lesser dog appears. Hello, lesser dog. Pet, 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 pet. Lesser dog, attack 12, defense 2. Wields a stone dogger made of pomegranate. Like a Pomeranian pant. Okay. Oh, hey, whoa, 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 whoa. Watch the dog. Whoa, doggy. Lesser dog cocks its head to one side. I'ma pet you. You barely lifted your hand, lesser dog got excited. Whoa. Tiny bark. Oh, come on. Oh, jeez, that wasn't good. Lesser dog is barking excitedly. Oh, his neck got longer. You lightly touched the dog. It's already overexcited. Pant, pant. Okay. Oh, okay. I think I got that one down. We're good. This is gonna keep going. You pet the dog. It raises its head up to meet your hand. Pant, 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 pant. Oh, jeez. That one's hard. Unless your dog is barking excitedly. Okay, let's keep petting you. You pet the dog.
It was a good dog. Excited noises.
Aha! Figured out how to get past you. Jumping, annoying dog. Plus your dog is overstimulated. You pet the dog, its excitement knows no bounds. Excited noises. Really kind of curious to see how many times I can do this. Plus your dog is overstimulated. I'm gonna keep overstimulating. Critical pet dog excitement increases. Plus your dog is overstimulated. You have to jump up to pet the dog. Motor revving. His tail's wagging. Oh my god. You don't even pet it. It gets more excited. Plane takeoff. What is going on? There's no way to stop this madness. Kettle whistles. Unless your dog shows no signs of stopping. Unless your dog enters the realm of the clouds. You call the dog, but it is too late. It cannot hear you now. Far away barking sound. Is there an end? Oh my god, its head's coming back down the other way. What? What is going on? You can reach Lesser Dog again. Hi, doggy. Bark. Oh, jeez. This is some insanity right here. Okay, I think that's enough. Lesser Dog is lowering. You can go now, Lesser Dog. Yeah, that happened. Moving on. Hello, I am a snowman. I want to see the world, but I cannot move. You can talk. Doesn't that count as moving? If you would be so kind, traveler, please take a piece of me and bring it very far away. Okay. Thank you. Good luck. You got the snowman piece. Oh, how cool. I wonder what this sign says. Ice. North ice. South ice. East ice. West. Snowden Town. And ice. Okay. Let's go find some more ice and Snowden Town. Oh, here's these two numbnuts again.
You're so lazy. You were napping all night.
I think that's called sleeping. Oh wait, if you're a skeleton, why do you have to sleep?
Excuses. Oh, the human arrives. In order to stop you, my brother and I have created some puzzles. I think you will find this one quite shocking. For you see, this is the invisible electricity maze.
Oh, that sounds wonderful.
When you touch the walls of this maze, this orb will administer a hearty zap. Sounds like fun. Because the amount of fun you will probably have is actually rather small, I think. Okay, you can go ahead now.
Alright.
He zaps himself. Sans, what did you do?
I think the human has to hold the orb.
Oh, okay. Hold this, please.
Sure, buddy. I'll take it.
Okay, try now.
You kinda showed me where to go, doofus.
Incredible, you slippery snail! You solved it so easily. Too easily. However, the next puzzle will not be easy. It is designed by my brother Sans. You will surely be confounded. I know I am.
Hey, thanks. My brother seems like he's having fun. By the way, did you see that weird outfit he's wearing? We made that a few weeks ago for a costume party. He hasn't worn anything else since. Keeps calling it his battle body. Man, isn't my brother cool?
Huh.
That's a weird one.
Oh, hello.
Who are you? I don't understand why these aren't selling. It's the perfect weather for something cold. Are you sure about that? Oh, a customer! Hello. Would you like some ice cream? It's the frozen treat that warms your heart. Now just 15 gold. 15 gold. Oh, jeez. I wouldn't pay $15 for some ice cream. Alright, whatever. Here you go. Have a super duper day. You got the ice cream. What's it do? Oh yeah, let me look at the snowman piece. It has 45 hit points. Please take this to the ends of the earth. Okay. And the ice cream. Ice cream. Heals 15 HP. Instead of a joke, the rapper says something nice. Aw. How cute. See, look at this guy. You know, he doesn't move. You leave him behind, but he keeps ending up in front of you. Like he can teleport.
I've been thinking about selling treats, too. Want some fried snow? It's just 5 gold.
Fried snow? Wouldn't it just melt?
Sure. Did I say 5 gold? I meant 50 gold.
Yeah, buddy.
Really? How about 5,000 gold?
Yeah, I don't even have that much money, sure.
50,000, that's my final offer.
Yeah, oh, I absolutely have to have that fried snow.
What? You don't have the money? Hey, that's okay. I don't have any snow.
What a troll. What do we have here? His. Hers. Smell danger rating. Snow smell. Snowman. White rating. Can become yellow rating. Unsuspicious smell. Puppy. Blue rating. Smell of rolling around. Weird smell. Humans. Green rating. Destroy at all costs. Ooh. They don't like humans. Okay. Well. Whee! It's like a little golf game or something. Not really a whole lot of point to that one. Oh, here we go. Next puzzle.
Human! I hope you're ready for... Sans! Where's the puzzle?
Right there. On the ground.
Trust me. No way they can get past this one.
I could just walk past it. Curiosity, though. Monster kids word search. Oh, jeez. Cigars? Odd. What else isn't even a word? Yeah, that's funny.
Sans! I didn't do anything!
Whoops. I knew I should have used today's crossword instead.
What? Crossword? I can't believe you said that! In my opinion, the Junior Jumble is easily the hardest.
What? Really, dude?
That's easy peasy word scramble?
That's for baby bones.
Unbelievable! Human, solve this dispute!
Which is harder? Crosswords are definitely harder. But Sans seems like he wants me to be nice to his brother, so I guess I'll tell him that the jumble's harder.
Haha! Yes! Humans must be very intelligent if they also find Junior Jumble so difficult.
I don't think that's how it works, buddy.
Thanks for saying Junior Jumble to just to appease my brother. Yesterday he got stuck trying to solve the horoscope.
He doesn't seem like he's very smart. Knowing the mouse might one day find a way to heat the spaghetti fills you with determination. Okay. What do we have here? It's a note from Papyrus. Human, please enjoy the spaghetti. Little do you know, the spaghetti is a trap designed to entice you. You'll be so busy eating it that you won't realize that you aren't progressing. I'm thoroughly japed again by the great Papyrus. It's a plate of frozen spaghetti. It's so cold it's stuck to the table. It's an unplugged microwave. All of the settings say spaghetti. Well, that's not really gonna do me a lot of good there, buddy. It's unplugged. They kind of need electricity to work. Plus, it's stuck to the table, so I can't get it out. Okay. Uh-oh. Ice Cap and Snowdrake confront you, sighing.
Jerry.
And Cherry, attack 0, defense 30. Everyone knows Jerry. Makes attacks 2 seconds longer.
Wow, you guys suck at this.
Oh, he makes the attacks longer.
Ow.
Well, that's irritating, mildly. Still, Rick is practicing its next pun. You and the other monsters ditch Jerry when it looks away. Nobody likes you, Jerry. Sorry. Smells like a wet pillow. Let's see here. Laugh at the snow drake.
Thanks, you're all great.
Well, this isn't super hard. And spare. Oh no. Jerry's back. Damn it, Jerry. You make everything take too long. The return of Jerry. I'll ditch you again. Get out of here. Nobody likes you. There we go. So, oh, this is like a map. So the switch is up over here. There's a switch hidden in the snow. Click. Cool. Now we can progress. And probably get attacked 20 more times. Uh-oh. Ooh, those dogs look kind of scary. They got some big axes.
What's that smell? Where's that smell?
If you're a smell, identify your smelf.
Do a little dance. Here's that weird smell. It makes me want to eliminate. Eliminate you.
Uh-oh. The doggy assault you. Dogamy. Attack 14, defense 5. Husband of Dogaressa. Knows only what he smells.
Don't touch my hot dog.
He means me. Oh. Oh, crap. Well, that was an interesting attack. The dogs keep shifting their axes to protect each other.
Aw, it's so cute.
They said, smelling. So, I don't think they want to be pet right now. Let's try rolling around. You roll around in the dirt and snow. You smell like a weird puppy. Ah, puppies are good. They like puppies. Number 2 nose nestle champs in 98. Of course we were second. Oh. Okay. Oh. Oh, oh. The dogs may want to re-smell you. Okay. Give me a sniff, guys. The dogs sniff you again. After rolling around in the dirt, you smell alright. That smells like a... Are you actually a little puppy? Yes, yes I am. You didn't know. But that's exactly what I was all along.
Oops.
The dogs think that you may be a lost puppy. Maybe now I can pet them. You pet dog of me.
Wow! Pet by another pup!
Well, don't leave me out. Uh-oh. Woo!
Idiot. Aha!
Let's pet Dogarisa. You pet the Dogarisa.
A dog that pets dogs. Amazing!
What a concept, right? Okay, well this one's easy enough to dodge. The dog's minds have been expanded.
Whoa, man. That's cool. I never thought of it like that.
40 gold, not bad.
Dogs can pet other dogs. A new world has opened up for us. Thanks, weird puppy. This blew their minds.
What a concept. Okay. Hit the switches and then hit the button.
Aha!
Hello, Papyrus.
What? How did you avoid my trap? And more importantly, is there any left for me?
What do you tell Papyrus about his spaghetti? It was good, man. I ate the whole thing. It was tasty.
Really? Wowee! No one's ever enjoyed my cooking before. Well then, fret not, human. I, Master Chef Papyrus, will make you all the pasta you could ever want. Aren't you supposed to be catching me?
He did it backwards. He seems awfully confused. And lonely. Hello, Papyrus.
My brother started a sock collection recently. How saddening. Sometimes I wonder what he would do without such a cool guy taking care of him.
Oh, what do we have here?
Human, how do I say this? You were taking a long time to arrive, so I decided to improve this puzzle by arranging the snow to look more like my face. Unfortunately, the snow froze to the ground. Now the solution is different. And as usual, my lazy brother is nowhere around. I suppose what I'm saying is, worry not, human. I, the great Papyrus, will solve this conundrum. Then we can both proceed. Meanwhile, feel free to try the puzzle yourself. I'll try not to give away the answer.
Okay. Thanks, buddy. Interesting. I think I got an idea. I'm gonna go da da da. Da da da. It's like one of those things where you gotta draw a line around without touching anything. Twice. Ta-da!
Wow! You solved it! And you did it all without my help! Incredible! I'm impressed! You must care about puzzles like I do. Well, I'm sure you'll love the next puzzle then. It might even be too easy for you.
He seems very amused by himself. Oh, hey, Sans, there you are. You must be really good at puzzles, huh? I mean, it's impossible for you to have seen this one before. See, he knows. He knows that I've played the game before. Sneaky. Oh, jeez, what is this?
Hey, it's the human. You're going to love this puzzle. It was made by the great Dr. Alphys. You see these tiles? Once I throw this switch, they will begin to change color. Each color has a different function. Red tiles are impassable. You cannot walk on them. Yellow tiles are electric. They will electrocute you. Green tiles are alarm tiles. If you step on them, you will have to fight a monster. Orange tiles are orange-scented. They will make you smell delicious. Blue tiles are water tiles. Swim through if you like, but if you smell like oranges, the piranhas will bite you. Also, if a blue tile is next to a yellow tile, the water will also zap you. Purple tiles are slippery. You will slide to the next tile. However, the slippery soap smells like lemons, which piranhas do not like. Purple and blue are okay. Finally, pink tiles, they don't do anything. Step on them all you like. How is that, understand?
Wow, that's a lot of colors and things to remember. Sure, I got you.
Great! And there's one last thing. This puzzle is entirely random.
Well, then I could make itself completely impassable, then.
When I pull this switch, it will make a puzzle that has never been seen before. Not even I will know the solution. Get ready.
Oh, geez, here we go. It's all pink and red. Womp, womp, womp. RNG did not like you. The machine isn't working. Actually, that spaghetti from earlier, it wasn't too bad for my brother. Since he started cooking lessons, he's been improving a lot. I bet if he keeps it up next year, he'll even make something edible. The snowman. Seems like the base of a snow dog. It's the broken head of a snow dog. Somebody was trying to make some really long snow dogs. Hello, person. A dog just rushed in here, filled with inspiration. It kept trying to build a snow dog that expressed its own emotions. But as it built, it kept getting more and more excited about the sculpture. Its neck got longer and longer, and it added more and more snow until it was rather sad to watch. But I couldn't turn away. This must have been the lesser dog that I was petting, whose neck got really long. Knowing the dog will never give up trying to make the perfect snow dog, it fills you with determination. Oh, ooh, ice puzzle. Okay. Looks like if I just go in a circle, it'll solve itself. So let's do this. Do do do. Skating around. Yeah, it's pretty easy. Do 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 do, and then hit the button. Huzzah! And little bridge comes out, and off we go. That little hat. What's down here? Oh, hi, Sans. What's up? Wait a second. See, here's where we see something odd. Oh, hello. A gift rot confronts you. Hello, gift rot. Gift rot, attack 16, defense 8. Some teens decorated it as a prank. Oh no, you poor guy. He's got like a dog on him and like a sticker on his head and some other things in him. Don't put any more on me. Oh, he doesn't want to be decorated, huh? You don't like people making fun of you, thinking you're a Christmas tree? I see with suspicion. Well, let's take your decorations off then, since it's upsetting you. You remove a small, confused dog. That's a little better. Still got some stuff on. Oh, jeez, that was close. Gifford is slightly less irritated. You can remove a childhood photograph of Snowdrake and his parents.
Ah, with Snowdrake, you did it.
Always making bad jokes. That's a little better. What a prankster. Oh, uh-oh. Ah, almost. Gifford is slightly less irritated. You remove the lenticular bookmark of the smug teen winking. A weight has been lifted. Gifford's problems have been taken away. Alright, he's good now. Wait, can I do anything else? Can I give him a gift? You give 35 gold because you can't think of an appropriate gift. Aw, you shouldn't have. Gifford's problems have been taken away. Goodbye. What a nice guy. Say, are you following me? Kind of hard to follow somebody who can teleport around magically. Ah, what is this door? It's a door. I can't figure out how to open this thing. If anybody knows how to open that door, let me know. It's been a rather confusing puzzle. It's a snow puff. And this is a snow puff. This, however, is a snow puff. Surprisingly, it's a snow puff. Snow puff. Is it really a snow puff? I don't know, is it? Behold! A snow puff. Eh? There's 30 gold inside this one. What is this? No, that is not a snow puff. That is a dog. Hello, dog. Bark, bark. Oh, it's cute. No, oh, it's not cute anymore. It's a huge dog. It's the greater dog. Hello, greater dog. His spear has a little dog face on it. Let's check him out. Greater dog, attack 15, defense 8. It's so excited that it thinks fighting is just play. Aw, he's not actually trying to hurt me. He's just confused. Bark, 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 brother, brother, brother. He's watching you intently. Come here, dog. You call the greater dog. It bounds towards you, flecking slobber into your face. Ew! Nasty. Ow. Jerk. He's seeking affection. Okay, I'll pet you then. Greater dog curls up in your lap as it is pet by you. It gets so comfortable, it falls asleep. Then it wakes up. It's so excited. Bark, bark. Bark, bark. Greater dog is patting the ground with its front paws. Oh, like a dog that wants to play. Alright, let's play. You make a snowball and throw it for the dog to fetch. It splats on the ground. Greater dog picks up all the snow in the area and brings it to you. Now dog is very tired. It rests its head on you. Aha! Greater dog wants some TLC. Alright, let's pet you, dog. As you pet the dog, It sinks its entire weight on it. It's a huge dog. I think I would be dead. Your movement's slow. But you still haven't pet enough. Oh no. How much do I have to pet? Oh, I am moving slower. Harder to dodge that. Pet capacity is at 40%. This could take a while. You pet decisively. Pet capacity reaches 100%. The dog flops over with its legs hanging in the air. It's adorable. I can move freely again. The greater dog is contented. Oh, I can spare him now. Alright, goodbye, greater dog. You won, and you earned 40 gold.
Oh, who's a great doggy? Who's so cute?
And it jumps in. It's got an ass for a face now. Ah, that's a long bridge. That doesn't look safe. Oh.
Human, this is your final and most dangerous challenge. Behold the gauntlet of deadly terror.
Oh, geez, that looks, actually kind of dangerous.
When I say the word, it will fully activate. Cannons will fire, spikes will swing, blades will slice. Each part will be swinging violently up and down. Only the tiniest chance of victory will remain. Are you ready? Because I am about to do it.
I'm a little hesitant there, buddy. Well, what's the holdup?
The holdup? What holdup? I'm about to activate it now.
There's a dog hanging. The scariest part. That it doesn't look very activated.
Well, this challenge, it seems, maybe too easy to defeat the human with. Yeah, we can't use this one. I'm a skeleton with standards. My puzzles are very fair. And my traps are expertly cooked.
Don't you mean your spaghetti?
But this method is too direct. No class at all. Away it goes. Phew. What are you looking at? This was another decisive victory for Papyrus. Yeah. Huh?
He seems very confused now. I think he's starting to like me. He doesn't want to hurt me. Sup, Sans. I don't know what my brother's going to do now. If I were you, I would make sure I understand blue attacks.
Okay. Sure thing, buddy. Oh, welcome to Snowden. I want a nice sign. Oh, they got a shop, an inn. The sight of such a friendly town fills you with determination. That's cool. Let's see, what's in the shop? Hello, traveler. How can I help you? I don't know. Hiya, welcome to Snowden. I can't remember the last time I saw a fresh face around here. Where did you come from? The capital? No. You don't look like a tourist. Are you here by yourself? Yeah, I am. What do you guys got to do here in town? You wanna know what to do here in Snowden? Grilby's has food. And the library has information. If you're tired, you can take a nap at the inn. It's right next door. My sister runs it. And if you're bored, you can sit outside and watch those wacky skeletons do their thing. There's two of them. Brothers, I think. They just showed up one day and asserted themselves. That's a weird choice of words. They just came out of nowhere and decided to be sentries. I wonder if they have some kind of authority.
They don't work for the Royal Guard, so that doesn't make sense either.
The town has gotten a lot more interesting since then. Town history. Think back to your history class. I didn't take one here. A long time ago, monsters lived in the ruins back there in the forest, yeah? That's where it came from. Long story short, we all decided to leave the ruins and head for the end of the caverns. Along the way, some fuzzy folk decided they liked the cold and set up camp in Snowden. Oh, and don't think about trying to explore the ruins. The door's been locked for ages, so unless you're a ghost or you can burrow under the door, forget about it. Alright. Can I sell stuff to you? Huh? Sell something. Does this look like a pawn shop? I don't know how it works where you come from, but if I started spending money on old branches and used bandages, I'd be out of the business in a jiffy. Again, another example of the game being self-aware and making fun of other games. Because usually, in any shop, you can just sell whatever you have. They'll buy it. They don't care. What do you have to buy? Ooh, a manly bandana. That sounds useful. Yeah, it's got some more armor on it. I'll take that. Alright. Exit. Yes. Goodbye now. Come again sometime. Suppose I should clean up my inventory some. Info. Manly bandana. Armor defense 7. It has some wear. It has our abs drawn on it. So it's manly. Alright, I'll use that. You equip the manly bandana. Let's put this stuff in here. Use the box. Yes. I'm gonna put that in there. I'm gonna put the pie in there. I'm gonna put the stick in there. And the spider donut. Keep the rest of that. Okay. What's in the inn? Hello. Oh, it's like a little kid. Hello, kid. Mom says that sleeping can recover your health above your maximum HP. Ooh. What's maximum HP?
I don't know.
Welcome to the Snowed Inn. Snowden's premier hotel. That's a play on words. I like it. One night is 80 gold. Jeez, that's expensive. Mm. Here's your room key. Make sure to bundle up. Okay. Oh, man. Got noisy people next door that snore a bunch. Because they sound like bees. What the fuck? Like making a song over there in their sleep. Rather obnoxious. Hiya, you looked like you had a great sleep, which is incredible because you were only up there for about 2 minutes. Well, that's about, yeah, literally, that's about what it was. Maybe a minute. Here's your money back. You can pay me if you're going to stay overnight. Another joke because they never actually have you stay, like, the whole night in-game for the rest, you know, just, it, like, cuts to the end of it. It cuts it out. So they didn't do that in this game. Actually, we're only up there for a couple minutes. That's funny. Oh, it does, actually, though. I did get the extra HPs, and I have 30 out of 20. Go figure. That lady over there. Something about her disturbs me. Why, because she's a bunny walking a bunny? Isn't my little cinnamon just the cutest? Bun buns are so adorable, hee hee. Ugh, yeah. I'm with you, dude. She's a little creepy. Who puts their kids on a leash? Awful teams tormented a local monster by decorating its tree like horns. We started giving that monster presents to make it feel better. Now it's a tradition to put presents underneath a decorated tree. Now that was the gift rot that I undecorated. Hello. Yo, you're a kid too, right? I can tell because you're wearing a striped shirt. Apparently that's what kids wear. It's like the the standard uniform. Yeah, okay. Who are you? This town doesn't have a mayor. But if there's ever a problem, a skeleton will tell a fish lady about it. A fish lady? That's politics. He sounds like one of those naysayer people, like the grumpy old guys.
Yeah, it's just the way they do you. I don't really understand it, but it's a bunch of nonsense, and I don't agree with it.
Oh, look, it's all the dogs! It's all the dogs. Hello, dogs.
Who's a doggy? I'm gonna pet you.
I'm thinking of getting a spiked collar to show off my personality. It makes a statement like, attach a leash to me and take me for a walk, please.
Well, we know what he's into. Jeez. That's a little, yeah.
Identify yourself. You better watch where you sit down in here, kid. Because that big guy will jump into your lap and give you lots of love and attention. Ooh, fierce. God, I don't want that.
We're sentries, but we never get any respect. I wish those skeletons would throw us a bone. We love bones. Well, you guys are dogs. He doesn't talk. It's playing poker against itself. It appears to be losing.
I put out a line for some girls today. Somebody told me that there are plenty of fish in the sea. Well, I'm taking that seriously. I'm literally going to make out with a fish.
Ew, you know, you could just go buy a fish. Oh, he's the dude who put the fishing pole in the water with the picture that says, call me. Those dogs are part of the Royal Guard, the elite military group led by Undyne.
She's rude, loud, and beats up everybody who gets in her way. It's no wonder all the kids want to be like her when they grow up. I guess for a monster, that makes a good role model. Who are you? The capital's getting pretty crowded, so I've heard they're gonna start moving here. I don't want to see the erasure of our local culture, but I definitely want to see some city slickers slip into their butts. Like one of those highly conservative country folk.
I don't know about them city folk coming out here and bringing all their fandangled ideas. We don't like that kind around here.
This guy's head is literally on fire. Grilb said that he'd offer you a glass of water, but he doesn't touch the stuff. Oh, she's talking for him. I guess fireman can't speak. Jeez, that guy's got a big mouth.
Isn't human food different from monster food? It does things like spoil. And when you eat it, it passes all the way through your whole body. Disgusting. I'd love to try it sometime.
Well, you know, maybe one day. Hey, Toriel had a chocolate bar in there you could eat. What's this guy?
No matter where I go, it's the same menu, the same people. Well, I want new drinks and hot guys.
I'm gonna get away from you. You sound annoying. Everyone is always laughing and cracking jokes, trying to forget our modern crisis. Dreariness, crowding, lack of sunlight. I would join them, but I'm just not very funny. We all know the underground has problems, but we smile anyway. Why? We can't do anything, so why be morose about it?
Yeah,
that's a good point. The Librarby? Well, that's not spelled very good. I think their education system needs some work. Oh, hey, it's Lux. What's up, buddy?
That look in your eye.
You're someone that has difficulty solving Junior Jumble, aren't you? He knows. Papyrus must have told people. Welcome to the library. Yes, we know. The sign is misspelled. I love working on the newspaper. There's so little to report that we just fill it with comics and games. Well, that's cool. Cough, cough. When I was younger, my teachers gave me word searches when they ran out of assignments. I thought they were a waste of time. But look at me now. I'm the number one word search creator in the entire underground. Oh, you're the one who makes word searches. What are all these books about? It's a school report about monster funerals. Monster funerals, technically speaking, are cool as heck. Oh, sweet, ours suck. When a monster gets old and kicks the bucket, they turn into dust. Oh, they just, like, dissolve. They, like, self-cremating. That's useful. At funerals, we take that dust and spread it on that person's favorite thing. And their essence will live on in that thing. Essence will live on in that thing. That's important. I can see that having some bad consequences, though. My favorite thing in the world is my Uncle Jim. When I die, I just spread all my ashes all over him. Just throw them at him. Am I at the page minimum yet? I'm kind of sick of writing this. While monsters are mostly made of magic, human beings are mostly made of water. Yes, this is true. Humans, with their physical forms, are far stronger than us. Oh, so they're, like, physically weak, huh? How do they build all this crap, then? They will never know the joy of expressing themselves through magic. They'll never get a bullet-pattern birthday card. I mean, you can. Here I am, writing this book. A person comes in and picks up the book. They start reading it. Oh, sorry. I'm still writing that one. Weird. It's like the meta book. Because they are made of magic, monsters' bodies are attuned to their soul. If a monster doesn't want to fight, its defenses will weaken. And then the crueler the intentions of our enemies, the more their attacks will hurt us. Well, that sounds like, not good. I guess humans are pretty darn good at killing monsters, then. Therefore, if a being with a powerful soul is struck with a desire to kill, let's end the chapter here. Yeah, they wouldn't be able to defend themselves. Monster History Part 4. Fearing the humans no longer, we moved out of our old city, home. We braved harsh cold, damp swamp land, and searing heat, until we reached what we now call our capital, New Home. Again, our king is really bad at names. Yeah, he needs some work on that department. Okay. It's a mailbox overflowing with unread junk mail. This mailbox is labeled Papyrus. Look inside? Yes. It's empty. Aw, Papyrus doesn't have any friends. Nobody wants to talk to him. It's locked. Okay, I'm gonna go save. Now I have to fight Papyrus. Not that he's super hard or anything. As Sans said, he's not really dangerous even if he tries to be. He's kind of a pushover. But, I think that's more of a take on his personality. I think he's actually pretty strong if he had the reason to be. Well, let's go have a chit-chat with the old Papyro.
What's up, Pappy?
Oh, it's getting white. It's all misty.
It's dramatic tension.
Human, allow me to tell you about some complex feelings. Feelings like the joy of finding another pasta lover, the admiration for another puzzle-solving skills, the desire to have a cool, smart person think you are cool. These feelings, they must be what you are feeling right now. I can hardly imagine what it must be like to feel that way. After all, I am very great. I don't ever wonder what having lots of friends is like.
Clearly, because you don't have any. I think he's projecting. Clearly, he's projecting.
I pity you, lonely human. Worry not. You shall be lonely no longer. I, the great Papyrus, will be your...
No. No. This is all wrong. I can't be your friend. You are a human. I must capture you. Then, I can fulfill my lifelong dream.
Powerful, popular, prestigious. That's Papyrus, the newest member of the Royal Guard.
Uh-oh. Papyrus blocks the way. Let's check him out. Papyrus, attack 20, defense 20. He's pretty strong. He likes to say, Yeah. I take it back. He's not very strong. Papyrus is trying hard to play it cool. I don't want to insult him, so I guess we'll flirt with him.
Hey, handsome skeleton boy. I like your, battle body, as you call it.
What? Flirting? So you finally reveal your ultimate feelings. Well, I'm a skeleton with very high standards.
I have zero redeeming qualities. I can make spaghetti. Actually, I can make spaghetti.
Oh no! You're meeting all of my standards! I guess this means I have to go on a date with you! Let's date later after I capture you.
Okay. You're gonna have to try a little harder there, buddy. The Papyrus is thinking about what to wear for a date. Okay, well, he doesn't want to flirt, so I guess we'll just keep sparing him. It's like the fight with Toriel.
So you won't fight. Then, let's see if you can handle my fabled blue attack.
Absolutely no moving. You know, if this wasn't blue, it would actually be almost impossible to dodge. What? Oh, you mother... You're blue now. Yeah. Yeah. Thanks. Oh, so it's like gravity. So I can jump. Okay. So let's just suddenly turn into a Mario platformer.
That's my attack.
Oh, man. We're blue now. Even the menu part's blue. The music kicked up. Things about to get fun.
I wonder what I should wear.
Oh, now suddenly this attack actually has some importance to it. Aha. He's trying good now. Papyrus taps some bone cologne behind it.
Bone cologne.
That's suggestive.
Hey, baby, I put out some special bone cologne for you.
Thinking about that date thing. Sure, buddy. You just can't stop thinking about me, can you? Oh, man. Woohoo! Papyrus dabs marinara sauce. Oh, gross. Well, he does like spaghetti, so, you know.
Yeah, don't make me use my special attack.
Bring it on, buddy. What do you got? You think you got game? Oh, oops. Bring it on. I'll take your special attack. Papyrus dams MTT brand Bishy cream behind his ears. Ew. That sounds gross.
I can almost taste my future popularity.
Yeah, he's definitely wrapped up in that. This guy's so full of himself.
Whoa, sneak attack!
Ha ha! Try harder than that. MGT brand anime powder.
That's great. Papyrus, head of the Royal Guard.
Yeah, keep dreaming, buddy. Hey, geez, he's getting creative now. MTT brand cute juice behind his ear.
Papyrus, unparalleled spaghetti ore.
I mean, maybe.
Woo!
Oh, oops, I forgot. Can't move through those ones. Oh, shit.
Attraction slime.
Ugh,
nasty. Undyne will be really proud of me.
Who's this Undyne you keep talking about? I'm assuming this is an important person. Jeez. Calm it down, Papyrus. Beauty yo- ew, yogurt.
The king looks through my head in the shape of my smile.
I mean, if that's what you want.
Woo! Woo!
Alrighty. Papyrus realizes he doesn't have ears, he's just wiping stuff all over his skull. It's got like spaghetti sauce and powder and cream. That's gotta look kinda nasty. You might wanna go dunk your head in the water there, buddy.
My brother, well, he won't change very much.
Hey man, Sans is cool, leave him alone.
Papyrus is rattling his bones. I'll have lots of admirers, but...
But what, man? You can have lots of admirers. You just gotta believe in yourself. Have some confidence. Well, he has tons of that.
Papyrus is considering his options. I don't know what to do. Will anyone like me as sincerely as you?
Nah, probably not. I got your back, bro.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
Aha! Oh, they're moving now. Oh, shit.
Aha!
Papyrus is trying hard to play it cool.
Someone like you is really rare.
Oh! Oh, I don't like that one. Oh, jeez. What do you got, man? Oh, he's... Oh, you think that was funny, huh?
And dating might be kind of hard.
Nah, that's cool, man. Trust me. I'm a cheap date. It'll be fine.
Ow!
Papyrus whispers...
After you are captured and sent away.
Sent away? Where, man? You don't even know what happens when they send me away. What if they try to cook me? It smells like bones.
Who cares? Give up!
No, I don't want to give up, man. You're gonna, like, try to, like, send me to some weird prison thing. That doesn't sound fun at all. Papyrus is trying hard to play it cool. Come on, man. Give up or face my special attack. Let's see what you got. Let's see this special attack of yours. I think it's so good. I could take it.
Papyrus is cackling. Very soon I will use my special attack.
Very soon, huh? When? Let's get to do this. Oh, got the jumps.
Not too long and I will use that special attack.
All right, man. You keep saying that. I'm not seeing it, though. Oops. This is your last chance before my special attack. Last chance. You said that like 2 times ago. I don't believe you anymore. I think you're full of it.
Behold my special attack. Aha!
The dog got it.
What the heck? That's my special attack!
The dog dies.
Hey, you stupid dog! Do you hear me?
It looks up.
Stop munching on that bone! What are you doing? Come back here with my special attack!
Well, that's a disadvantage of having all these dogs in town. You should have thrown him a bone. He may have not had that problem.
Oh, well. I'll just use a really cool regular attack.
The pirate's just getting ready for a regular attack. Alright, let's see it.
Here's an absolutely normal attack.
Okay. Alright, what do we got? Oh! Nope! Oh, crap. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Oh, I couldn't get away from that one. Oh, there's the dog again. Cool. Dude. Oh, we're just going up and up and up and up. I got the jumps. I got mad hops. Woo! That was cool. Oh no. Oh no, what do I do? Get away from me! No! No! No, stay away!
Well, it's clear you can't defeat me. Yeah, I can see you shaking in your boots. Therefore, I, the great Papyrus, elect to grant you pity. I will spare you, human. Now's your chance to accept my mercy.
Okay, I'll spare you, Papyrus. Oh, jeez. What a joker.
Jokes and japes and puzzles.
I can't even stop someone as weak as you. Undyne's going to be disappointed in me. I'll never join the Royal Guard, then. My friend quantity will remain stagnant.
What should you say? Hey, man, I'll be your friend.
It's all cool, man. I don't want you to feel bad. Really? You want to be friends with me? Well, then. I guess I can make an allowance for you. Wowee. We haven't even had our first date, and I've already managed to hit the friend zone.
Yeah, and you're staying there, buddy. Don't get any ideas, you and your bones.
The bone cologne.
You knew that all I needed to make pals was to give people awful puzzles and then fight them.
Yeah, it's a great way to make friends.
You've taught me a lot, human. I hereby grant you permission to pass through, and I'll give you directions to the surface. Continue forward until you reach the end of the cavern. Then, when you reach the capital, cross the barrier. That's the magical seal trapping us all underground. Anything can enter through it, but nothing can exit. Except someone with a powerful soul. Like you. That's why the king wants to acquire a human. He wants to open the barrier with soul power. Then us monsters can return to the surface. Oh, I almost forgot to tell you. To reach the exit, you'll have to pass through the king's castle. The king of all monsters. He is... well, he's a big fuzzy pusher. Everybody loves that guy. I'm certain if you just say, "Excuse me, Mr. Dreamer, can I please go home?" he'll guide you right to the barrier himself. Anyway, that's enough talking. We'll be at home being a cool friend. Feel free to come by and have that date.
What the? Oh, these skeletons, man. There's something else. Oh, there he is. Too funny. Well, let's see here. Let's save after that little fun adventure. The sight of such a friendly town fills you with determination. Yep. Okay. So, I think I'm gonna stop this video here for now, and the next time, we'll have a date with Papyrus, and see what's after Snowden. So, anyways, hit the like button if you enjoyed it, and please subscribe to my channel. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you next time.